Welcome back to the next episode of Winnie's Travels. In this episode, I'll just be going over the sort of miscellaneous steps that I took to finish up working on the exterior and finish the weatherproofing, waterproofing process of fixing up Winnie's old exterior. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so here's what the weather stripping on the front window looked like before I fixed it. But since Winnie's front is so big, it was honestly hard to get a good picture that showed both sides. So I went ahead and had fun with some graphics so you can tell that, well, the weather stripping is not where it's supposed to be. I used the leftover construction adhesive that I had to reattach it, which worked okay, but I did have to apply a clear caulking in addition, since there were still some areas where water would have seeped in if I hadn't caulked as well, since the weather stripping was so old.
This is the strip. This thick strip is what went all the way around here, and there was a little T section that was just as thick as the rest of this that went here, but I lost that, or at least, I didn't lose it, but it wasn't with Winnie when I got her. So instead of finding and buying a little T section, I just used this thinner weather stripping. There's actually two pieces here, and those two pieces put together make a piece that's just as thick as the rest of it. So I just reused that stuff rather than buying a new piece altogether. And that worked out pretty well. I used construction adhesive to secure all of it, and then I caulked over it with clear caulking, and that worked out really well.
I didn't really film this process because, honestly, I didn't feel like it. But basically, when I removed the waste tanks from underneath Winnie in episode 5, I also had to remove the plastic molds covering the wheel well areas, and this one actually broke. What happened is that the metal piece that attaches to the base of the wall, almost like you would hang a picture frame, broke off and I had to glue it up. It's okay though, because in doing this, I learned that the wheel wells themselves were no longer securely attached on either side. This would mean that over time, any weight or pressure on the wells from the inside could cause the plastic wells to collapse onto the wheel. I'm gonna build wood frames around the wells for cabinet making purposes and such, but still, that's probably not a good thing. The screws had rusted and deteriorated, so I installed new ones by carefully pre-drilling into the old fiberglass and using the screws that I already had.
Okay, so here's what the wheel well area looks like now that I've fixed everything and reattached it and then gone over with a layer of caulking. The one thing to note is that the screw holes, the original screw holes are no longer where the new screw holes are. Say screw holes 5 times fast. And the reason for that is because over time, the screw holes grew too large and the fiberglass near the screws cracked and was no longer able, like you couldn't screw back into that same screw hole because it was no longer like viable basically. So I had to essentially use my drill and pre-drill new screw holes, and then that worked perfectly. So I'm kind of finishing up the last touches on the exterior walls. So this little, I thought this line of caulking right here was where the water was seeping in, because basically the edges of the floor have been leaking all around. So I figured I just like the caulking on like the whole RV is really old, so it would make sense that it was leaking, but it's actually not this line here. There's this flap right here that you can see I can pull back. Like it just comes out. And this little piece where, like I thought the line of caulking was, because there is a line of caulking here, but this is just actually like a weather strip, basically like a plastic piece that the water's supposed to kind of like flow off of this so that it doesn't get into this like big crack here. And there was originally some caulking here. You can see, I'll take pictures of it close up, but it's just like covered in dirt and it's really old. And so it just basically the adhesive that was like connecting this little piece of plastic to the bottom of the wall is just falling apart. So I just have to basically with new construction adhesive, re-adhere this part to this part, like the two pieces together. And then what I'm going to do is caulk over the line of construction adhesive, also apply a layer of caulking, because this part definitely needs to be super watertight.
So yeah, the first thing I'm going to do is take a piece of, not a piece, take a cleaning wipe. Most of the time I try and use soapy water and a towel so that I don't end up running out of these, or like that, because they're more expensive than soapy water, obviously. But for something like this, these are really, really handy. And I haven't been using a lot of them, so I'm going to go ahead and use this. So the one other thing I want to show you, or like the other thing that I have been doing on these lines, is that it's a good thing to like spread the caulking out, or the construction adhesive, with usually like a paint scraper thing. But I've been using actually a toothbrush for this case because there's not really enough space. There's too much stuff in the way. So I just kind of have been using a toothbrush right after I caulk it and just rubbing it around, so that the adhesive is really, you know, stuck in there. And it's also really fun and really cheap and free, because the fun was just in my bathroom. Watching everyone, that's all for now. And if you're interested in staying in touch with Winnie's Travels, you can subscribe to my channel over here, or you can get started with the first episode over here. See y'all next time.